will start. I've left the door open there just in case there are latecomers. So now, you can take photos and videos throughout the show. Feel free. We are recording it, and we will send you a link to that, so you will get a full archival version of that. They've been working really hard. The show, by the look of it, is going to run 40-45 minutes, somewhere around there. They've got two group numbers they're doing, and then they've got all these little solo things, which we always encourage them for them to do stuff. Okay, the first one they're going to do is, before we start, can you please either mute your phones or do whatever you need to do to make sure they don't ring? I've just realised I may not have done that to mine. The first one they're going to do is I Just Can't Wait to Be King, and they're all in that one.
Should I let my heart keep listening? Give me the world.
Now we have Sophia, Evie, and Carolina doing Bad Blood.
Baby, now we got bad blood. You know it used to be mad love. So take a look what you've done. Baby, now we got mad blood. Hey, now we got problems, and I don't think we can solve them. You made a really deep cut, and baby, now we got bad blood. Hey, did you have to do this? I was thinking that you could be trusted.
How you always looking so amazing. Swear to God, it's like I don't really have a baby. You don't gotta play hard, already an all-star. Like you're overrated. Got me thinking like, alright, a song just not. But no, nobody eat this part. No, nobody eat this part. Maybe that's why, I'm always trying to pick a fight. When there's nothing I don't like about you, cause you're
so perfect. Everything you do is so perfect. Wake up in the morning so perfect. You ain't even gotta go to work. You're so perfect, you're so perfect. Everything you do is so perfect. Wake up in the morning so perfect. You ain't even gotta go to work. You're so perfect. Don't know what you do.
Extreme to the other. I'm two periods down here. I know we'll be very proud of that moment. We have Lexi now doing it. Last I See the Light.
Never even knowing just how
Now we have Charlotte, Claire, Elizabeth and Layla. They'll be doing Queen of Mean, which will segue into a little acting scene between Charlotte and Elizabeth called What Really Happened in December. Vincent doing Wishing Well.
Hello.
It's like a shorty's like an infield. Perky got me itching like a hell. Drugs kill me softly like hell. Sometimes I don't know how to feel. Ringing, I woke up on depression. They use my memories against me as a weapon. On the other line, I talk to addiction. Speaking of the devil, all the drugs I did make. This can't be real, it's a fiction. Some of this phony fiction. I cry out for help, do they listen? I'm gonna be alone till this finish.
Now we have Elizabeth doing Tomorrow. Copacabana.
They say, oh my God, I see the way you shine. Take your hand, my dear, and place them both in mine. You know you stopped me dead when I was passing by. And now I beg to see you dance just one more time. Ooh, I see you every time. And now my
Harry and Vincent will do Believer. Zoe will do Lean On. The second group number they've been doing, and this is Rotten to the Core from Descendants. And just shuffle back a little bit so everybody can get that. Make sure it's a nice neat line in the front. That's cool. That's good. That's where you are. Photo. You take a group photo now if you want. Now a silly one. Good, thank you. All right, just sit down for me. Good, so they've worked really hard over the last 3 days, and some of them have been with us for the 5 days now. So I would probably imagine they're going to be almost as tired as I feel by the end of tonight, and they'll sleep well. Sometimes after they've been through an experience like this, it's sort of like an emotional roller coaster, and they might be a bit teary tonight or tomorrow. It's just part of the fatigue that's gone on because they've burned a lot of energy they don't realise. So I explained to them, they did some scientific work on performance to find that the amount of energy that you use in a full-length show is about the same as a football player uses in a full game because the adrenaline pumps all the time. So it is quite exhausting. Is anybody tired?
Yeah.
No.
Sweaty.
Sweaty.
Hot. Hungry.
Hot.
Hungry.
I'm hungry.
I'm tired.
Hungry.
Hungry.
Thank you.
I'm hungry.
One of the there's many skills they learn as part of this teamwork and the discipline of being in a performance. But one of the most important skills, which I told them would be the hardest, was keeping quiet in the green room for that entire period of time. And you did very well. That's really well done. For those of you who wish to know the secret of how to keep your child quiet for an hour, I will be imparting that to you for a fee of $50 per hour. I'm really proud of them, and we've enjoyed having you here. If you like the approach we do as Papa, which is really about, it's nurturing more than, we don't go in for pushing kids into doing something that they're not ready for or they don't want to do. That's their decision. In a number of ways throughout this, they've been in control of it more than we have. They've opted as to what they want to do and how long, and we just shape and guide them and all that sort of stuff. I think it's really vitally important for me that they engage with and have fun at this stage, and then we can build on that later. And I'm seeing the long-term effects of some of the people that have been with us for a while are starting to score the successes now and are being told that they are really adaptable, resilient and flexible performers. And they're crediting that to the fact that they had teachers who told them how to play. And that is the important part. It should be play and fun. If it's not, believe you me, as a performer, myself over 40 years, you don't go into this profession generally for money. You go into it for love. So if you don't enjoy it, you're in the wrong profession. But I'm seeing delight written on their faces, and I'm really proud of the fact that some of them turned corners and, you know, got up there and did something that was terrifying. So if you do like what we do run classes, there's a little plug, we do run classes during the school term in Subiaco, Maylands and Yanjiba, and we are expanding, we'll keep going further and further, we just want to build this as far as we can. Because I actually, as I've said before, I want to steal away the kids from other experiences that are not so positive, so I don't care if we take them from other schools. If those schools are doing what I think they're doing, I'd rather do that. Anyway, Innie has been working like an absolute, I don't know what's the correct term to say now, but she's been working her butt off throughout this, as she always does. She did all the lighting and the sound and stuff. To get a song list like that together with the backing tracks in the space of an hour or two, and they keep changing, is quite extraordinary in itself. So thank you, Innie. Alice has been supervising and really being the workshop coordinator for this entire section with them. She choreographed the routines, and Alice is sort of, she's training to be a drama teacher within the school system. She's about to go on prac, and so this experience has been a brilliant experience for her to prep her for what's coming within the school system. So thank you for giving Alice a wonderful time, and I'm sure you thank Alice for giving you a wonderful time. Please drive carefully when you go home. We're hearing all sorts of terrible things. I can't believe that footage from Subiaco. That's amazing. Just watch out on the roads. Be careful when you're going through the hall, the foyer here, because the floor is a little bit slippery from leaks in the roof we've discovered. Thank you for entrusting your children to us for this entire period of time. Please take them home. See ya.